Okay, I'm just going to talk a little bit about the decoding functions TTN. And as I mentioned in a previous session, is that you need to be very careful about how you send your data. It should be as little as possible. So when you're using LoRa or Sigfox, please make sure that you're sending the absolute least information wise that you can do. So think about how high resolution do I really need for my data. To take an example is that if you have a temperature sensor that maybe measures a value between 0 to 60 degrees Celsius. So if you know what you're doing and you know that this is the range which I'm going to send my data, you can, by only using one single byte, get a resolution of 0.23 degrees Celsius. If you both in your on your device and in the decoder on the application take care about this, but then you need to know it in both ends. But otherwise, if you're fine with just using 1 degree Celsius within the range of 0 to 255, I would suggest just using one byte. Even better, perhaps, if you want minus degrees, is that you use the signed byte for that one. So we want to use as little data as possible. And what we're going to need is, and you can do it this in different ways, but it's a very easy and neat way to do it is using the struct library in Python. Also in the other end, there is a good video from the Things Network of how you should write your payload function. I'll show you just now as well. So let's just skip back to the code here. And I'm already connected with my sensor, and I can send whatever I like. Let's see, I'll send, I need to send a byte. So let's see, I'll send number one. So I sent one byte. And how does this look in the data? You can see payload one. And I can see also there is a counter and a port. And I'm sending at port two if I want to change that port. I can do that by the sbind function. Send it a four instead. Send number two. You can see now that I have the payload number two on port four. You can see some metadata here, 25 milliseconds. So I'm sending one byte and it takes 25 milliseconds to send that one. Okay. And if I now want to send a temperature value, let's say that I want to send a temperature value between 0 to 255, which is the resolution of one byte. I have the struct library, and just to show what you can do if you want to convert to hex or binary, is that if you just write hex, and let's say I'll write 255, this should be FF. Yeah, it is. And you can see here that they have 0x. That means this is hexadecimal. You can do the same thing if you want to convert to binary. You get this to binary, and the 255, this is 8 bits, obviously. So hexadecimal, it's 2, it's FF, and that's the base of 16. And in binary, you have the base of 2. And then, well, it's all ones. The first one is 128, and then 64, and so on. We'll have to read up on the binary system and hexadecimal if you want to dig into that. The most important thing now is that I want to send only one byte and not anymore, because I might be satisfied with that resolution, and I want to keep the data as little as possible. So I'll write in this case struct, and then I'll pack this. And if I want to read up on how this struct library works, you can. Now when we're only sending one byte, you shouldn't really have to care about little endian or big endian. But what I'm going to do is to have a signed character or an unsigned character, and what that means is, and also the standard size you see is an integer in one byte. And signed character or unsigned character is if there is a plus or minus, or if it's only plus. So if it's an unsigned character, then you have the resolution of 0 to 255, but otherwise it's -128 to +128, so it's just moving between those points. So let's see, then I'll write, let's say I want unsigned 255 and 255, it should be FF, and